creating dependent drop-down lists in Google Sheets can seem quite tricky at first, but they're actually quite easy once you figure out this one trick. Let me show you. Okay, so I'm going to create two dropdowns. The second dropdown will be dependent on the first dropdown. The information I have is about division and the apps that belong to each division. So this means that the first dropdown has the name of the division. Then once the person selects the division in the second dropdown, they can select the app, but they can only see the apps that belong to that division. Now this here is my master data. Now I've organized it in two different ways because you might have your master data either in a tabular format or in a report format. It doesn't matter how they are formatted, it's just important that you figure out the right formula to get this done. So I'm going to do both versions here. Pick the one that fits your data best. In a tabular format, our divisions are in a single column, and then in front of it, we have the app that belongs to the division. In the report format, we have the divisions as the headers, and then we have the apps that belong to that division underneath it. Same data, organized differently. Okay, so now I'll start off with the tabular format first. I need the dropdown for division. Now, the great thing about Google Sheets is that you don't need to get the unique division in a separate list. The data validation automatically gives you the unique record. So we basically don't have to do anything. We just have to go to data, data validation. I want list from a range, and my list is right here. Now I can go to the bottom of the range, or I can leave it open-ended so that I don't have to worry about where the data ends, and go with okay. I also want to reject input if the selection is not from the list, and click on save. Now, just one thing I'm going to mention right now is that just for simplicity, I've put these on the same sheet where I'm doing the dropdown, but that's not going to be the case in the real world. You're going to have these in a separate master data tab, and you're going to have your dropdowns in your final report, right? So you're going to keep these separate, but I didn't want to keep moving back and forth and get you dizzy with that. So I put them for practical purposes on the same sheet. Now the steps you do when they're on a separate sheet is identical to what I'm showing you here. You just have to click back and forth to make your selections. Okay, so notice that I got the first dropdown and the values here are unique. Now comes the difficult part. How do I create a second dropdown list that only includes the apps that belong to the division here? Now the thing with the Google Sheet data validation is that you can't put a formula directly inside the formula box. You need to do it on the grid somewhere and then make a direct reference to that range inside the data validation. Your formula doesn't go inside the box here. Your formula goes on the grid. Basically, what you end up doing is creating something called a data preparation list. So what formula can I use here to get the apps that belong to the productivity division? A great function for that is the filter function. I have a detailed video on this. In case you want to find out more, I've added the link to the description of this video. The range is the range we want returned. We want the apps. Now I'm also going to leave this open-ended. Next, the condition. Well, we want to include every single app where division equals this division. So that condition is to check this range. We have to be consistent with our height of the range. So I'm going to remove that reference. If that equals this one right here. And that's it. Close bracket, press enter. And I have the apps that belong to productivity. Now, if I change this to utility, I get the apps for utility. Now, all I have to do is go to where I want to have my data validation, go to data, data validation, and do the same thing. This time, reference my data prep, and I can also leave this open-ended, click on OK, reject input if it's not from my list, and save. And now check this out. I get the apps that belong to utility. Now, if I switch this to game, I get the apps that belong to game. Okay, so that's if your data is structured in a tabular format like this. Now, what if we have this type of structure? Well, let's just group these together. Let's start off with a dropdown for division. Let's go back to data validation. The range this time is horizontal. That's no problem for data validation either. Reject input and save. We have the first dropdown. Now the second one. We know we need to do a data prep. Let's do it on the side here. What formula can I use to get the members of each division? Well, again, it depends on what type of formulas you know. My favorite function, or one of my favorite functions, is the index function. The reference is the range that I want returned. That range is the range of possible answers. Possible answers are here. Now again, it's up to you how much you want to reference. This time, let's just go to 30. We don't need to go all the way down. 30 should be enough. Okay, so that's my range of possible answers. Next is, how many rows do we want to go down? Well, we want to include every single app. So I'm going to skip this because I want to include every single row. Last one is the column. Here I can match it. I'm going to use the match function. What am I looking for? This one right here. Where am I looking it up? Right here. And I want an exact match, so I have to put a zero here. Now, I also have a video on index and match. If you're curious to find out more, link to it will be available. So close two brackets, one for match, one for index, press enter, and I get my results spilled. So I have utility, that's why I see this column. If I switch this to game, I see the apps that belong to game, and productivity, the ones for productivity. Now that I have the hard part done, I go to the easy part, data validation. My list is right here. Now again, we can go as much as we did before. I think it was 30. Click on OK and save. And we have the members of the productivity division. Now there is one thing you need to keep in mind, that if you've already made your selection and then you go back and you change a division, this one becomes invalid. It still shows it, but it's invalid. So you have to click, and the moment you click on the dropdown, you will see the right members. Problem is, this doesn't automatically reset when you change it. To make it reset, you have to use AppScript. This is something I cover inside the Google Sheets masterclass. Now you might be wondering, what if I wanted this repeated on multiple rows? So what if I wanted to have 10 rows that has a dependent dropdown list? That's something we're going to cover in next week's video. So that's how you can create dependent dropdown lists in Google Sheets. You just have to get creative with what's available to you. If you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And if you like what you see on this channel, you want to improve your skills, consider subscribing. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.